So, managing transaction exposure. So now we know that what are our expenditures and incomes in different foreign exchange rates, and we know that we have to be afraid of Czech koruna. Then we can choose between the following issues. So, total hedge. Actually, in this case, we can say that. So we have mostly expenditures in Czech koruna. So, in the past, I was always using this annual perspective, but maybe we can try to check what is happening when we are focusing on mostly issues, because practically we have to pay all expenditures on mostly basis, so we are much more closer to realities here. Or we can say no hedge. We tested it last week, what happens here. So and also we can choose selective hedging. So hedging only when the market benchmark has signs higher market risk than the average. This will be for next week. So for today we are trying to play with this here. And we are trying to prepare our MATLAB script to do that. So first of all we need a plan. Yeah, we did it last week. So let's say that this will be A. Total hedge. Because there are lots of data or supporting number for us here in this, and also if we are going for. Wow, where is it? There's supposed to be an option pricing component somewhere. Ah, there are all the data details. Yes. So actually, if someone wouldn't like to use the MATLAB script to calculate the values of the option, then this is a semi-automatic Excel file. So if you are giving the spot rate, the strike price, volatility, interest rates, we are not switching the time to maturity in days, then actually it calculates the call price or the put price of the option. And even you can define the specific amount of money, and somewhere it will say that how much money should be pay in this case. So yeah. So actually is this thing can be really useful for us. So right now we know that we have some exposure here in Czech koruna. In CZK. And we know that it's okay. I will increase the size of this because in this case you have a chance to see it. So it's coming from the profit and loss statement data. So all what we can see is that this is the summing up everything what we can find. No, without. We are skipping the depreciation because we know that this is just artificial thing from accounting, and also we know that what is our preference. Or let's say preferred CZK HUF exchange rate. Let's say that we want to keep it as 10. 10 is a nice number. I like it. So in my strategy, I will try to maintain this exchange rate. Actually, what would happen if I would keep it as 10? Then our profitability would increase drastically. Oh my god, that much. So, what is the price of this thing? for the option fee, if the spot rate is 11, so let's start with the initial scenario, and I'm trying to pursue my strike price that 1 year later I have to do and pay this, I have some sort of volatility, and the domestic interest rate is defined here. Foreign interest rate in Czech Republic. Do we have data about this? Let's go back to the case study, because in the case study we find prices and fees. No, there is nothing about PRIBOR, so let's go to so this is the Prague Interbank Market overnight rate, and we can see that this is the benchmark interest rate, which is 0.43%. It's not that much, but it's something. And time for maturity in days. Let's see, let's use annual option right now. And we can see that this is the core price to purchase 1 Czech kruna for a foreign. No, sorry. Other. So the option and call option fee for 1 CZK. In this case, we can say that this nice number here. This nice number wouldn't like to come here, but now it is. And so this is just an annual option. We did something here, so actually. Price or expenditure due to the hedge, we can say that at the end of the day we have to multiply this number and this. And this will be in HUF, so it's not in Czech kruna, because otherwise that would be really, really strange. So I mentioned that it's so nice that we have this such amount of profit here, because I was modifying from the 11.4 to 10, so it generates us 56 million forints. Just if we are saying that now we have an option fee here, look. Oh my, okay, maybe this is not the. Because maybe it's already linked. Okay, it's too intelligent. So let's say that 8 interest plus hedging fee here. So it's not coming from this direction, it's coming from here. And we can say that now our welcoming profit disappeared. So it's bad for our business. Still, we have to improve the company, so this is the original setup here. And after that we can say that let's fire everybody from. What is happening when we are firing everybody from Czechia? As you can see, it can be a welcoming solution, because now it's profitable. But okay, we can't do that because that's a nice thing. So that's why you were changing the company's corporate strategy to improve the efficiency in a different way. So that would be the price of total hedging. But can we do it better? So right now, this is an annual assumption. But we have to say that actually we are not operating on annual basis, we are operating on monthly basis. Monthly expenditure in CZK will be this number divided by 12. Yeah, still we have our preferences in the exchange rate, still we have, but now we don't have the call option fee, because right now what we have here is it will be different options will be needed. So let's say that we will covering all of our expenditures at the end of the year, so we will need option. For 11 months, 10 months, 8, 7, 1. So something like this until we are paid, and then we can hedge down everything. Obviously, we could do the same thing by changing the numbers here, but it would require work, and you know that I'm much more lazier than that. So let's see that how can we do this in MATLAB, since it's fast and nice. Oh. Okay. And still we need the data for that. But actually, okay. Do you want to play with this vanilla instrument objects? Yes, we're supposed to, because the university paid a lot of money for that, so we have to use this one here. So, once it's able to read in the data, oh my god, we don't have MATLAB toolboxes, but why? Okay, so for some reason it disappeared, but I will re-upload and install this, so... because we have a friendly matlab.exe for another course, so we'll just have to... save our codes. Ah, matlab.exe is already here. Then there is everything what we need. And work with that. So right now we have to think about that, which data do we want to use and test? Still we need a starting point. So let's see that we start here in the January of 2020, which will be in the 332 date. Okay, in this case we can type it terrible way, so let's say the time. That's much better. 32. We need the timestamp for later purposes, and we are reading in everything. Obviously we need standard deviation of the data, and yeah, I'm not sitting at Kis Gábor, I'm sitting at Tanár. This is a different computer, yeah.
Teacher,
yes, yes. So the username. It's different, then we can see that actually we have the standard deviation. And now we don't need the four cycle yet. Yeah, because it will be. Yeah, because actually the four cycle will be needed to compute. Now this stuff, we can close it. So we need to compute the different expiry of the options. So we can say that we can keep the four cycle here, just we have to change the references. So spot price 10. Now the spot price is calibrated to 30. Wow. Okay. Then target price is 10 because it's nice and simple. Sigma, let's see what is the sigma here. This is the sigma, and then the foreign rate is this. Actually, this part it completely, absolutely doesn't matter, because I don't know why they kept this way. So mostly if I'm checking the different parts of the financial instrument toolbox, they were introducing this because it's much better to price in swap contracts. But for options, it's highly useless to have this exercise date issues, because you have to calculate or calibrate only the lengths of the option in years, or maybe months, but that's all. So we have to play with this calibration here, but actually the time doesn't matter, so we can turn it to 20 and first day, but it has absolutely no impact on anything. Rate will be defined by time, basis, annual interest payment, and it's a call option, and after that, yeah, we were not switching this thing away, because good. So let's see that is this working or not before doing anything further. Do we have error message or not? Oh, it's long. It's not supposed to be that long, but yeah, okay. So we can see it's still an annual option, and price is what we are looking for. Boo. Yeah, because it's always for the same day. Okay. Yeah, because I already changed everything to time, so this is 1.20 something. Is this the same? It's not because my initial data, input data was different here in the options, so let's cross-validate it, because I'm not trusting in any of the systems. Volatility is sigma. Domestic interest rate. Rate. How can they call this way? So MATLAB is usually an elegant thing, but this is not that. Foreign rate. Yeah, and it is supposed to be percentage, so we have to divide it by 100. I mean 100. Nice, and it's supposed to be 3. What is this? It's not 3. Awesome. Okay, let's use the old-fashioned way, which works. So I'm just changing this because at least I know that I can trust in this script. Because at least I was writing this. Yeah, still it's it's not 3. Okay, now it's not the mistake of the MATLAB, because it's consistent. Is the volatility strange? What was that? Wall. Yeah, because it's in percentages, but it's converted efficiently. Oh my god, this is not divided well. Now it's 3. Okay. So that was the problem. It's always tricky because if you are using not percentages but basis points in interest calculation, then it can be completely misleading, as you were able to see. Okay, now then let's start to calculate the difference, because now we have to say that we need mostly. And then we are increasing this by multiplying it with I. So 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, and so on. Until 12 months. So changing the T. And now we have something like this. And this is why we are doing this, because actually here we can save money. So if you are hedging everything for why the short term is lower, or yeah, it's higher. Actually, this way is more expensive. Yeah. Oh, then this is not the business of the day, of the here, because actually this case is much more but if you want to hedge, then it's not about the expenditure, it's about the accuracy. So still we have to continue with this, just I had other illusions. Just you know that if it's short-term business, then it's supposed to be lower, but yep. And the ordering is not right, because we have to change it. Because I change only the arrangement of this. Now it's valid. Okay, so this is the fee. H2F. And now we can see that what is the price of safety here. we don't need this. Oh, but we have to fix this position here because otherwise it will go sideways. So actually, we spent even more money. All of this stuff, but actually we can say that now at least corporate profitability is secure because we can plan with all of these expenditures. Ah, but there is a problem that right now we are calculating two different scenarios because this is the actual spot rate. Yeah, we have to go back to 11 something. Or we can say that somehow I have to connect the original case study with the other one. Because in this case we cannot have a comparison, so option fee have to be changed. So in this case, and actually in this case we have to still assume that for the last months of the year we don't have any kind of hedging, so or still we can say that let's hedge the entire year. Because it looks stupid that we don't have this. So actually, price of precision is it's not that much money actually. So we can say that it can be counted only in hundreds of thousands of forint. So after that we can say that okay, how can we build all this stuff into first let's say this So how can we build everything and all of this into this case study? So let's, how can we evaluate that the company operates, and then we have different exchange rates and it should be react on all of this stuff. So obviously what we have to modify here is the financial position of the, so the bond interest payment plus hedge will be added here, and actually we have to define a hedge and no hedge switch here. So if hedge equals zero when we are doing no hedge at all, then actually profit and loss statement remains the same as if hedge equals one, then total hedge for CZK. Then we have to add something here, which can be referred as what is the name of the call option? Yeah, European call, for example. European call multiplying the this. Sorry. The PLS 1-1 because it already. No? Because we don't want to hedge the depreciation, that would be useless. New line. So we are summing up. In the profit and loss statement, everything between the second line, second row, and the six. In the first column, this did not define anything, but it's supposed to be that one. So let's read it in. What do you say that you can't find this? IFM input 2000 is not available. Ah, because I renamed it. Okay. Then let's save an original copy for that because we need this for testing purposes. You can see it. Let's define one locomotive and all this stuff until a bit, and we are reaching hedge. Then we can see that is this the, what is the sum? Okay, somehow it's looking for an end. And you got your end. And what is the sum? This is the number. Is this the same number? Yeah, this is the same number, that is good. And after that, now we have only one thing. First of all, to close down this decision tree. Then we have to calculate the actual call option fee. and to integrate the call option fee calculation into the script. It will be a bit longer. And also we need a hedge switch. And it's a double equation because we are looking for the exact number here. So let's put this here, that this is zero under no hedge and one at total hedge. And after that, we can think about it that where should we include? Oh my god, there is also cat inside of it. Okay, before that, we have to save as edge. So the cat should be removed. Or not, because actually we can use this data set for our agenda, since if we are defining the right standard deviations, if we are defining the right interest rates, then we can include the option pricing here as well. So, we can include it here. So let's say CZK STD, like standard deviation. For each year between lots of years. If I remember well, it was maybe annual data, what we collected last week. But we're not supposed to do the same thing, because if we are just calculating the standard deviation here on this weekly data, then we are just taking out the annual data from here, then we can skip all the unnecessary steps. And then we will just integrate the output. So from the previous script part, we are loading in that we have the HT, but this is a weekly, so we have to collect the annual STD conditional standard deviation, so conditional because it changes in time. So for I equals 1 to len length of the data, this is the HT, so we have weeks like a lot. Then we know that there are 52 weeks in a year, so you have such amount of years. We need a floor, no, we need a round. Yeah, round it up to 15. And just we have to say that annual STD. And then we just taking the HT, we are multiplying it by 52, because in this case, in each year, we get the last end of the year standard deviation, the last one, but we have to take a minus 51, because in this case the first data will be available, because we are doing the hedging in January, not in December when it's over. And we are taking this out, and still we have to have the square root S square T square root, because we need not variances but standard deviations, and this is on squares. And now, sorry, annual. And now we have it. But still, it's supposed to be. Yeah. It's supposed to be not in a, as a column, it's supposed to be a row, so we have to transpose it. This way. We don't need that. And now it looks nice, because now we just have to copy it into the other code, into friendly position. And see, we can think about that, how many years do we need? Because maybe it's a bit excessive. Okay, we need just 11 years, so we don't have to copy all of them, just the last 11. Yeah, obviously we need such amount of this. I'm not sure that in this way we can. Ah, you can read this. Okay, then we're not supposed to change anything. It looks disgusting, but it works, so it's good. Also, what do we need here? The same thing is for interest rates in both currencies. So we are doing the same modifications for WHO and for CZ, for the without the square root, because that would be crazy. And what was the name? Edu 10 epsilon. And CZ 10 epsilon. Then we can see that actually what will be your annual interest rates. And we know that we just need this, not all of them. Then still we can bring it here. So okay, let's say that who 10 epsilon, it's not, this variable is not used here in this part of the script, so you can just include them. And also we can have the CZ 10 epsilon a similar basis. And after that, after did all this stuff, we can say that now we're just adding the option pricing part of the script to this game, because we don't want to import this as well. Let's make it at least a bit intelligent than it is. but it cannot use I because we are already using I. So let's use already cat. So let's use dog. Actually, we don't need put option fee here, so we can skip this. And after that, we can say that okay, this is a CZK. Everything again, loading in the data. Loading everything until cat equals 1. Loading everything until we are reaching the Garmann-Kohlhagen pricing option. And then let's see that is this thing working or not. Spot rate, we have a spot rate. Target price, we have target price. T equals, it's for the mostly, then this is not time, this is cat. Okay, maybe time would be much better variable name for cat, but yeah, forget about it. And okay, that was terrible. And wall was what? STD. At least I was consistent here because we just have to take it and but it's a row vector, so we have to change the coordinates because otherwise it will cry badly. Good. Yeah, no, it's still the opposite one. First row cat column. So good. Then we have all the calls. Yep, and actually, we can say that I don't want to mingle with all the mostly issues. So actually, if you are summing up the European calls and then multiplying with the exposure, it will be the same. So we don't need additional variable. Just I was looking for that. And after that, things are happening. Until we are reaching the hedging point, then we can say that we have to sum all these things together. We have to multiply. It's in Hungarian forint, and then it will go on and it will be inherited by the other parts of the script, so they will be happy with that, I'm sure. Okay, so let's see that without switching this hedge thing on, this is able to run or not. Nice. I don't know what I'm looking at, but it's colorful. It's a probability of default. Okay, and is this thing operational if I'm turning the hedging on? Oh, it's much more colorful than before.
it looks like an origami to me.
Yeah, because it is.
Maybe trying to fly.
Yeah, just it's that.
Three dimension? What is the third dimension?
So actually this is the probability of default, so it's clearly 1, 1, 1, and if it's not 1, then it's 0 point something. So it says that, okay, if the exchange rate is... Oh, it's... Right now we are parametricizing the years. Yeah, that was the cat. Yeah, from 1 to 11 years. So this is the 0 year.
Mm-hmm.
For from this direction, so from 0 year from locomotive 1, and actually it doesn't matter for them that we are hedging or not hedging because they are still dead. So, but if you are looking on the other side of the origami, and I'm finding the right angles for the camera, then actually we can see that there will be differences amongst the different locomotive strategies, because it still can deviate away. But this is supposed to be better than this. Why are you so ugly? Let's see the pretext ratio, because maybe... Oh! I think that something wrong happened. Or not?
What is 1 to 4?
This is supposed to be the profitability ratio, which was positive in the past, but now it's not. So something wrong happened when we turned on hedging. Yeah, because it's supposed to be something like this, so... It started to use hedging to avoid risk, and now I kill the company, so... So far so good. Okay, call options, we validated this part because... Yeah, it's familiar data for us, so... We already checked this, so it's good. Then the error should happen later on. Ah, yes! I know where is it. Just I have to find the right part, it's not validation. A bit... Yeah, this is... So, actually what I did here, that I was summing up all the mostly option fees, which is... 40 forint for each check runas. Just what is really important here, that we have to divide this by 12 to make mostly expenditures, because otherwise this is where the hedge mark should be located, because in this case it's fees from there, as if hedge equals 1, then this is ZK, hopefully will be 10. And it's end. And now it will be... Do we have the same results? Looks similar from the other direction. This is also the same. And now if we are turning on the hedging, and now it's able to eat the right exchange rates, and it's also calculating with the option fees, it still be expensive. But now it's option fees are now not that great because we are using them. Now let's locate this somewhere. So this is at all. And of course we can say that this is the pre-tax margin here, and these are locomotives. So the pre-tax margin, these are the locomotives. And still we can say that there was some sort of variation. The profitability, but now it's supposed to be
in our balance sheet, yes,
but it refers to PNS.
Good enough. And in other dimension, which is there. Ah, everything's supposed to be good.
Yes, of course. I might.
Just for me, they are looking finally the same. Let's compare maybe the probability of default, because so this is under hedging circumstances. Now it's good angle. So we're supposed to see something, some sort of improvement here. But since we are deviating so much from the then exchange rate, then it creates everything more expensive. Okay, yeah,
Yes.
Well, it's supposed to be this way. Actually, in this case, hedging was able to reduce risk of probability of default, at least. So we can say that here we have lower numbers, like than or compared to here. So at least it's spending lots of money on options can reduce probability of default by 10% maybe, or 10%-ish something. So this will be there. We can say that, oh, okay. It's not that much, but at least it's visible. And of course, we can still see the value of shares. Are they affected? So value of shares. That's something like this under hedging. No, that was the not hedging. And if we are turning on hedging, then something will at least supposed to change. Actually, we can see that at least at some levels we had a significant improvement here, because now the company works a bit more than before because we are using options. Not just we were able to reduce a bit the probability of default, but also it has a nice impact on share values as well. Not here and here neither, but in during the recent years at least it had some feedback. Maybe if I should rescale this. This is much better because it starts here and here, and now they are on the same scale. So actually, with spending a lot of money, we were able to save maybe 2 fiscal years, and that's all. Okay, so that was our lessons for today, and I think this is the craziest. No. Next week, when we were talking about value at risk, how can we combine value at risk into selecting that do we want to have options or do we don't want to have options? So to define that we are using only options under market stress periods, it will be a bit more crazy than this, but but this is, it was the real hardest thing, because we have to define that we are hedging anything, Then we have to define the underlying conditions of hedging. So what are the exchange rates and then the standard deviations. Then we have to integrate somehow in the option pricing issue, and also we have to integrate it to the profit and loss statement to have also the option payment related expenditure here. So yeah, but it looks nice. So that was all for today.